Hey everyone, it's Monica. So I'm here to do a video on this flower. I did go ahead and do a haul, a Sue Wilson dye haul, and I didn't show them cut out because I was going to do this video showing you the flower assembled. So I guess you can call this a new series, so to speak. You guys are all aware how I do my dye feature series, how I usually pick one dye and do a video on it and go over my pros and cons for it. So I'm going to do something similar. This is just going to be, a flower feature series. So what I'll go ahead and do is it'll either be a dye or it will be, a SVG file. It will most likely be purchased from the Silhouette store, but it'll go ahead and feature flowers. That is probably, aside from my dye questions, my flowers are probably one of the most requested, items, either to show how I made them, to show the dyes, to talk about them. So I decided to do a little series. How frequently I will do this, I don't know. It's kind of whenever I work it into all of the other things I have going on, but I will try to keep them relatively short. So this is going to be the first flower in the flower feature series. Okay, so this is the Creative Expressions Layered Carnation Dye. This is a Sue Wilson dye. As I'm sure you guys are all aware, I love Sue Wilson dyes. So this is a newer dye that I've just received because I always look for different type of flowers. I'm not big on purchasing flowers. I used to buy the mulberry flowers and I kind of just lost interest in them. But for my own cards, I prefer to make them myself. So anytime I see a flower dye, 9 out of 10 times, I might buy it depending on who the maker is. So this die here, you get 12 pieces. You get 5 different size petals for the flowers. You get 3 different size leaves. And you have these little centers here that you can do to create a different type of center of your flower. Now, I will admit, the centers that usually come in these flowers, I very rarely ever use because I prefer to use the metal filigree flower centers. So for demo purposes, I will not be using the flower centers that they have. So again, you get 5 different petal sizes. So you can get a flower ranging from the largest die is approximately 2 inches. The next size down is going to, wait, is that one 2? Yeah, that one's 2. Oh, you know what? I'm measuring it. I should measure them the same. Okay, honey, I'm recording a video. Can I cut it for you as soon as I'm done?
Almost longer.
Maybe 5-10 minutes. I promise I'll come down and cut your grapefruit, okay? Close the door,
bye.
Baby. That's my little one saying hi. Okay, close the door, baby. Okay, sorry about that. So let me, I love you too, honey. Let me go ahead and measure them the same way. So this one, this way, is approximately 2¼ inches. The same direction for the next size down is approximately 2 inches. The next one is this one down here is about 1 5/8 inches wide. The next size down is 1½. And the smallest one is 1¼. So you can get a variety of sizes and flowers ranging from 2¼ down to, what was this, 1¼. And it all just depends on how full you create your flowers is how you get the different variations. So I did 2 different types of flowers. And the first one is a much fuller flower. This is cute. I probably won't use this one as often, but this one's very, very full. So for this one, I used, let's see, 3, is it 3? 1, 2, yes, I used 3 of the large one. 1, 2, then 2 of this size, 2 of this size, and 1 of this size. So again, just depending on how full you want your flowers, you can go ahead and just keep bunching them up together. So that's one style, and that's just using a gem in the center. This one here is how I will most likely use this flower. This is probably my favorite. So for this one, we have 2 of the large. Then we jump down to two of this size, which is the third size down, and two of the smaller ones. And then I used my metal filigree center there. So I'm actually going to create the smaller portion on video, because the process is exactly the same for all of my flowers. It never changes. They're simple, quick, so that's how I like to create them. So I'm just going to create a smaller version of this one, but I'm not going to use the larger petals. So here you have two of the larger size and two of the smaller one. Now, that is my main rule of thumb when I typically go with flowers. I will usually use two layers of each size. So the only time I might drop it to just one, it will be the very center, the very last one that I add. Depending on how full my flower is, I might only use one. But in this case, we're going to go ahead and use two of each. And very quickly, this is what the leaves look like. This size is the largest one. I did not cut out the other two, but this is just to give you an idea of what the leaves look like. So for all of my flowers, same anytime I do a tutorial, I use a pair of tweezers. If you don't have tweezers, you can use a paintbrush, anything that you can go ahead and curl your flowers up. I just fold mine up. You can use, again, a rounded paintbrush and roll your flower up to give you more of a cupped look. I just fold mine in half over my tweezers. And I do it for all of the petals. Again, my form of making flowers, there's nothing complicated. Now, there's so many people out there that create such beautiful flowers. They take the time, they use the flower shaping tools, they wet their flowers, they color them, and while they come out gorgeous, I do that occasionally. But for the most part, since my crafting time is limited, I like to be quick with it. So the quicker the better. I don't need my flowers to look realistic. My cards and my projects are all over the top, nothing realistic about them. So to me, this is my preferred way. And you just kind of just get the basic shape. Just again, fold it up. And that is essentially all that I do as far as shaping is concerned. So I'm gonna go ahead and take adhesive. I usually use the Nuvo Deluxe adhesive, or I use my Art Glitter Dries Clear Glue. These are my two favorite liquid glues. They both dry clear. I do also love Fabri-Tac, but Fabri-Tac is expensive, so we don't use that as often. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this. And I just put a little dollop in the center. And then I'll go ahead and take the petal that I'm gonna go ahead and glue down. And I just basically offset them so they're facing opposite directions. It gives you a fuller flower. And that's it for that. Then I'll take my next size down. And you can do this with your hands. I always pick it up with my tweezers since I have long nails. Just makes it easier. Again, offset the petals. One in the center there. And if they flatten out while you're gluing them together, that's okay. Once it's glued together, you can go ahead and fluff your petals back up. And as you can see, I'm putting quite a bit of glue on it, so some of it is oozing out every once in a while. And it's okay because it will dry clear. So here is essentially the base of my flower. Now, all it's gonna do is I'm gonna add the center, then I go through and I cut the petals more to give it a more fluffed up look. And then that's it for my flower. Now, I'm going to go ahead and do this flower center here. This is my favorite ones. I use them all the time on every flower practically. When you're gluing metal to paper, the best glue to use is Glossy Accents. These type of glues, like the Nuvo, the Dries Clear, while they'll hold it down they'll get the job done, but they're not very good. They're not very strong when it comes to metal. You will be able to rip it off. And I personally don't like my projects to be damaged, so I use a Glossy Accents. I believe the Judikins 3D Lacquer, Crystal Lacquer, I think that's the maker, is similar to Glossy Accents. So I just put a dollop in the center and go ahead and add. push it down, and that is it for the flower. Now for my leaves, I never keep them flat. I do the same thing like I do for my flower. Put my tweezers in the center and I cup them up. Granted, depending on how I lay it out on my flower, does not necessarily mean I'll keep it so the leaves cupped up as much. I might flatten them out a little bit depending on how I arrange my flower. But there is essentially your little flower with the leaves. So that is basically it for this die. Again, it's just to go ahead and feature the die so you can see how the flower looks assembled in some manner. Granted, you can get different looks from all of these flowers by the way you shape it, how many petals you put in. You can get creative and decide how you want to go ahead and do it. This die does have a coordinating stamp set. I have not gotten it yet, so I'm sure you'll see it in the future when I do eventually get it, when I use this flower. But if you have dies that do have a coordinating stamp, you can always get those, because that also creates a different look to your flower and gives you many more possibilities. Alrighty, if you have any questions, comment below. I am going to be working on a card with these flowers, so you will see a card relatively soon. It might not necessarily be the next video, but you will see one soon where I use this on a card. But the next card for sure will be used creating these flowers. Alrighty, if you have any questions, comment below, and I'll catch you guys in another video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.